Guys, let's move away from this one. Let's talk grassroots now. Let's come back to Lagos. Lagos is doing a lot of things right. A few months ago, the Lagos State government talked about bringing the Barcelona Academy to Nigeria, to Lagos, to be precise. And that happened officially on Saturday. The FC Escola officially got off the ground in Lagos on Saturday at the Teslim Balogun Stadium. And that makes it the third school in Africa after Cairo in Egypt and Casablanca in Morocco. Nigeria is the first sub-Saharan, sub-Saharan country that is hosting and having the Barcelona Academy.
Yeah.
And that's huge. And it all started on Saturday. And we are hoping that this is not... we are hoping it will be successful, given the amount of talents we have. We are hoping it's a massive step that the Lagos State government
replicating Lemasa, bringing it down to Nigeria. I mean, it's something that is long overdue. It is a welcome development. It gives our youth the opportunity of learning the foundation, of the game, at the local level, managing their skill and talent and channeling it into a particular direction and technique helps them to mold it. Talented players, discover and mold them and put them in shape for international competition. It is a welcome development. It is.
Oh, yeah. Let me get your word on this one as we wrap that up. It's a good one. The Lagos State Football Association also have an arrangement with PSG. I like the fact that all of these things are happening, and it's a big opportunity for us to get the structure of youth football right in this country.
Absolutely. So, when you look at the way Iniesta, Xavi play, you could trace it back to the foundation.
Mm.
A good footballer must, control the ball well. That is the first thing, the basic, and this is the level at which they are taught all these things. We have seen some of our footballers, you try to control the ball once, twice, three times, and, the first touch is always very important.
Very important.
So this is the level. And if you get it right here, Tony, you will agree with me that in the next 5 to 10 years, we will produce very spectacular footballers.
Mm. The dynamics that it will bring to our game is something that we desperately need in terms of technique. That it will help to enrich our game, make it more robust.
If we didn't have all of this and our football, the talents that we have are like this, then you can imagine
what will happen.
What will happen if the basics are taught early in life for boys and girls?
Very true.
And they are refined. We will dominate.
Definitely.
We will dominate. All right. We wish them the best. And we hope that all of these investments will not be a waste. But let me also spend some time still talking grassroots and talking about school sports, school football. Talk about the Lagos Private School Cup. All right. I'll just run through for you some of the results before, as we prepare to go on a break of the Lagos Private School Cup that is going on in Lagos. I hope the slide can come quickly on your screen so that we can just run through it before we go on a break. It's a good initiative for boys and girls. For the boys, you can see the results on your screen. Barakel, I hope I didn't murder the name of the school, beating Zagab 4-3 on penalties. And in the final, Caleb beating Ronning School 4-3 in that one. That's for the boys. The girls also had their... at their turn, it was Humat College 2-0 over Ronick School in the third place, and then Good Shepherd losing 0-1 to St. Joseph, that's your school, Joe, 1-0 in the final for the girls. Lagos Private School Cup. We commend Prince Wale, my good friend, for putting that together, and we wish him the best of luck with it. Let's go on a break. When we return, MPFL Match Day 11 on Sports Tonight. Join us again.